Hello, and welcome to a very different kind of video to what I normally do. Quite a few people have done videos on the history of the Daleks, taking a look at everything to do with them, but not in massive detail. So today I will talk about the history of the new Dalek Paradigm, also known as the new Dalek Power Rangers. So without further ado, let's begin the video. The story of the new Dalek paradigm begins during the Time War, an era where time was constantly changing, but this didn't stop the Dalek time strategists from seeing the future of the Dalek Empire's encounters with the Doctor, noting that their histories were deeply connected, citing the new Dalek paradigm as one such encounter. The source of their creation stems from the post-Time War new Dalek Empire, as when they were destroyed by the Children of Time, one ship managed to survive, being hurled back through time to World War II. These three Daleks, the last in the entire universe, managed to locate the last surviving progenitor device from the last Great Time War. It contained pure Dalek DNA, and the means to recreate the entire Dalek species. However, the progenitor did not recognize them as Dalek, so they began a scheme called the Ironside Project. When the 11th Doctor arrived in World War II at the request of Winston Churchill, they managed to trick him into giving his testimony, meaning that the progenitor could now be activated. Five Daleks were created, with larger casings, colour-coded ranks, and pure Dalek DNA. Each Dalek had a position in the new Empire. Red was the drone, yellow the Eternal, orange the scientist, blue the strategist, and finally white, the Dalek Supreme. Their first actions were to exterminate the three older, impure drones, something they embraced. After revealing that Edwin Bracewell, a creation of the Daleks from the Ironside Project, was a bomb, they forced the Doctor to let them escape through a time corridor, allowing them to build their new empire. And build a new empire they did. Because of the Time War changing events constantly, they couldn't verify much of the information on the Dalek pathweb, prompting them to distance themselves from their ancestors and take full advantage of the Time Lord's absence. When they reorganized themselves into a new Supreme Council, they began building a new army of drones at the weapons facilities on Goth, a planet previously used by Sontarans and Cybermen. They also discovered a lost Time Lord artifact known as the Eye of Time. It allowed them to change time as they saw fit, essentially making them the new Lords of Time. They returned to Skara with the Eye and rebuilt it, appointing a new Emperor who was installed in the capital city, Kalan. In this new timeline, they invaded Earth during the 1960s and killed every member of the human race. However, these events were undone by the 11th Doctor and Amy Pond, restoring the true timeline which returned Skara to ruin. The Dalek Supreme, not the original, led an attack on the SS Lucy Grey to recover the time axis. They were yet again defeated by the 11th Doctor, who fired their ship into the sun. They escaped their fate, but were later again defeated by the Doctor, who flung their ship into a black hole using his TARDIS. At the beginning of the 40th century, the Daleks began another war with humanity that continued into the 41st. During this time, the 11th Doctor and Amy Pond encountered a group led by a chief strategist that had a mission to find a Dalek mutant that was being experimented on to make it less aggressive. After slaughtering all resistance, they finally found the mutant nicknamed the Abomination in a hidden base, but were destroyed when it disabled the reactor safety measures, the Abomination surviving. The Paradigm later joined an alliance to imprison the 11th Doctor inside the Pandorica to save the universe, but since the Doctor was not responsible for the collapse of existence, the Daleks were destroyed, leaving only two stone Daleks, one of which tried to hinder the Doctor's plans but failed. Ultimately, they were restored along with the rest of the universe. When searching for information on the Silence, the Doctor found a badly damaged Supreme and used its databanks to obtain said information, leaving it to be destroyed. At an unknown time, the Paradigm were led by a new Emperor that planned to remove Gallifrey from existence and yet again try to become the new Lords of Time. They used a piece of the Eternity Clock to time lock 2106 London, but their plan was thwarted by the 11th Doctor and River Song, who boarded the Emperor's flagship and defeated him, taking back the piece of the clock. At some other point, a small group of Bronze Daleks were sent on a mission through Earth's history, studying how humans fought in war to find weaknesses for future conflicts. The 11th Doctor encountered them during the First World War, ramming a plane into their ship to crash it into the ground. The saucer remained underground for 100 years, until it was discovered by a team of archaeologists, but the Doctor returned just in time, connecting the ship up to a power line, overloading the Daleks. After being ruled by two Dalek emperors, a parliament was formed to take their place, led by the Prime Minister of the Daleks. This change in direction was motivated by the Paradigm's many defeats to the Doctor. The Prime Minister made many changes, like promoting the red drones from foot soldiers to an officer class, and reintroducing the bronze design from the Time War, as it was thought they would strike the most fear across the universe. The original five founders of the Empire reduced to a token presence, serving in only advisory capacity due to their many failures. The new Dalek Paradigm discovered the Cradle of the Gods, and learned of its ability to create or destroy on a massive scale. To make use of the weapon, the Daleks took advantage of a huge galactic recession to create 400 sunlight worlds, planets to house the billions of people affected by the recession. The sunlight worlds were governed by the Dalek Foundation, which made a generation of people believe that the Daleks were a force for good, creating a welfare state, but it was actually a plan by the Dalek Time Controller and Dalek Supreme to transform the 400 worlds into 400 copies of Skaro. The only flaw in the plan was that they were unable to activate the cradle, so they sent an anonymous message via Hypercube to the Doctor to hopefully manipulate him into activating the cradle for them. When he arrived, he was shocked to discover that the Daleks were seen as a force for good, and was then put on trial for trying to convince people of the Daleks' evil, something that they considered a hate crime. He was put on trial by the Dalek litigator, who was really the Time Controller in disguise. The Doctor pleaded guilty and escaped with three children. After failing to spark a revolution, the Dalek litigator caught up with the Doctor and put him on trial again, exiling him from the Sunlight Worlds. But the Doctor returned to the worlds 90 years in the future, where the Dalek litigator revealed its true form, forcing the Doctor to activate the cradle. However, a Dalek puppet who was an ally of the Doctor turned against its masters, forcing the Time Controller to retreat, allowing the Doctor to set the cradle to self-destruct, ruining their plans. When the Starliner Alaska crash-landed on the Dalek Asylum, compromising the security of the insane inmates, fearing what would happen if they were to escape, the Prime Minister ordered the abduction of the 11th Doctor. He was sent to the asylum with Amy Pond and Rory Williams to lower its force field so that the Daleks could blow it up, despite the fact that they wished to preserve them and their divine hatred. Once the planet's defences were lowered by the human-converted Dalek Osmin, the Parliament launched their attack on the planet, but not before Osmin used the Dalek's path web to remove all knowledge of the Doctor from their memories. When the Doctor returned to the Parliament to retrieve his TARDIS, they bombarded him with the question, Doctor Who? The sudden gap in the Daleks' knowledge sent them into a frenzy, stalling their war effort while they attempted to discover the identity of the enemy that foiled them so many times. The Daleks, along with many other species, were drawn to Trenzalore by a mysterious message. They had tried to decipher it remotely, but found that it wasn't in any known language. After the message was translated by the Doctor, the Dalek Supreme recognized it as a question asked by the Time Lords through the crack in the universe, with the answer being the Doctor's name. If the question were to be answered, the Time Lords would return and be fired upon by the forces above Trenzalore, starting a new Time War. To avert this, the Church of the Papal Mainframe set up a force field around the planet, and so the siege of Trenzalore began. The Daleks called for reinforcements and prepared for war. Eventually they attacked the mainframe, killing everyone before converting them into Dalek puppets. Using the information harvested from Tasha Lem, their forgotten memories of the Doctor returned, driving the Prime Minister mad. Deeming the Prime Minister now unfit for duty, the Dalek Supreme exterminated it, resuming control of the Paradigm. They revived, tortured, and killed Tasha several times, in an attempt to learn how to break the force field. The Daleks then lured the Doctor into a trap, but Tasha Lem broke free from her conditioning, destroying the Dalek sent to kill the Doctor. Despite their trap failing, they still managed to breach the force field, and 5 centuries of fighting ensued until the Daleks were the only species left. The Doctor and the Silence Priest acted as the last line of defense, but were overpowered and the Doctor had run out of regenerations, leaving him old and weak. With the resistance dealt with, the Daleks descended on the town of Christmas, with attack ships and a huge flying saucer. However, Clara Oswald successfully pleaded with the Time Lords to save the Doctor, giving him the ability to regenerate into his 12th incarnation. The energy released was enough to destroy a couple fighter pods, and a final burst destroyed the mothership, ending the war. Human historians believe that having committed all their might to stop the Time Lords returning, the Daleks had been totally defeated, though given their resistance, they weren't quite so sure. At an unknown point, The combined galactic resistance formed to combat the Daleks and captured a damaged Dalek named Rusty. Historians claimed that Rusty was a Dalek from before the Time War, saying specifically he was a unit from the ending phases of the Dalek Wars. Another account claimed the Resistance fought in the Great War, but Rusty had access to memories of events after the Time War, implying he was part of the Paradigm. The Resistance asked the Doctor to fix Rusty, as he had been turned good. After the radiation leak causing his moral change was sealed, he turned evil again, breaking free from his cell and calling for Dalek reinforcements to destroy the Aristotle. The Doctor and Clara attempted to reactivate Rusty's suppressed memories, particularly that of a star being born, making him more susceptible to the Doctor's influence. They succeeded, getting Rusty to see the good in the universe, but it sort of backfired, as the beauty that Rusty saw was the Doctor's hatred towards the Daleks. He destroyed the entire boarding party on the Aristotle. Rusty then left, continuing his crusade against the Daleks. After leaving a young Davros to die during the Thousand Year War, the 12th Doctor was taken to Skara by Daleks that showed extreme respect towards their creator, though he admitted that he had no control over them. Dalek control on Skara was made up of Dalek variants and casings from various points in their history, but not the casings of the original Paradigm. While the new Dalek Paradigm showed no interest in their home planet after the formation of the Parliament, the Daleks had restored Skaro and the old Dalek city, making the planet the centre of the Empire. Davros planned to use the Doctor's regeneration energy to create Time Lord Dalek hybrids, but this plan was stopped when the angry Dalek sewers also received the energy, rising up and destroying the city. At some points after the events on Skaro, the Daleks began showing up a lot less. The 13th Doctor implied that she was entirely rid of the Daleks, and therefore the Paradigm too, though the 12th Doctor had encountered a Dalek harvest ship during his travels with Bill Potts. When a reconnaissance scout was revived for a second time, it created a new Dalek race on Earth posing as defense drones. Knowing that the only way to beat them would be with other Daleks, the 13th Doctor called a Dalek death squad from the Time Vortex to deal with them. It's assumed that they were a part of the Paradigm. In an alternate timeline, the Dalek Time Controller, while working with the Queen Master, took over Earth from Paris 1921. By 1961, Earth was known as New Skaro, with Sontarans, humans, and Draconians being converted into a new Dalek Paradigm. And that was the story of the new Dalek Paradigm. If you enjoyed watching, please consider leaving a like and subscribing to my YouTube channel down below, as a lot of work was put into this. If this video does well enough, I might make more about other eras in the Daleks timeline, or maybe even other monsters. Thanks for watching.